will be doing the next video again on software application lab, that is STAD Pro problem number 2. So problem number 2, again it is a continuous beam. So analyze the continuous beam as shown in the figure, draw the shear force and bending moment and deflection curve. So you have the continuous beam, there is only a hinge support at the beam. It is of complete 10 meters span, which is carrying an UDL of 5 kN per meter, then 25 kN and 6 kN per meter and another 20 kN point load. So we will be analyzing this beam using the software called as STAD Pro. So we'll come back to the STAD Pro. So as we have seen in the first problem, so first we have to go to the configuration, select the IS456 and IS800 for RCC and steel design. Then go to new project, select plane, then give the file name as experiment number 2. Then your units will be in meters and kilometers, kilonewton. Tell OK, finish. Then go to the job, add the job details. Before that we are adding the notes now. So before that we have to add the notes as shown, or first you have to give the job information. So job information is continuous beam, client name will be your name, then job number, this is experiment number 2, so give 02. Engineer name will be your name. Checker and approver is the faculty who is handling the lab. Then go to the geometry. Once you click the geometry, we have 10 meter span. So 0, 3, 6, 9 and 10. It will be continuous. Then take add beam option. Add the beam. Then go to the support property page. Add rectangular has the property 0.45 by 0.4. That is depth and width. Tell add. Use cursor to assign the beam or assign the property to the complete beam, that is continuous beam. There are 4 beams, add the property. Then go to the support page. As we don't have fixed support, only pinned support is there, that is the hinged support. Select support to use cursor to assign the load, assign the support. Then go to the load page, load case details, add the load type, that is dead load. Give the name as dead load. Then add live load, give the name as live load. Add, then highlight dead load. Add the self weight of the beam is automatically created by the software itself. Then highlight live load. Then member load, in that you have two uniform loads, two concentrated loads. So two uniform loads is, one is -25, distance is 3. Add, then another you have -20, that is downward force 20. So -20, again it is for 3 meter span. Then tell add concentrated force, you have 2, one is 25, which is downward, so again minus, so it is for 1.5 meter, means mid span we are going to take it. So 1.5, another is 20, which is again downwards, -20, overhanging beam 1. So we have to assign the loads. Assign the load, sorry, the UDL load is 6 and 5. So change the UDL from 25 to 6 and from 20 to 5. Okay, use cursor to assign, highlight self weight of the beam, assign the self weight to the complete beam, then highlight uniformly varying load, assign, use cursor to assign, assign. So uniformly distributed load -25, use cursor to assign, assign concentrated load which is at the mid span, use cursor to assign, assign, then concentrated load 20 which is at the overhanging beam, assign the load. Then you have to display the dimensions. So dimensions are displayed. Then if you want to increase the scale and decrease the scale of the loadings, you can go to the scale and labels, scale, apply immediately, decrease the point load, increase the distance or decrease the distance force, so it is visible to you all. Even you have to go to the loads, tell load values to be displayed, so it will get displayed. Even you can see the load values also are being displayed. Analysis print, add, close, then go to analysis, run the analysis, save the file. You have got zero errors, zero warnings, done with the analysis part. Then highlight shear force in y direction, scale, apply immediately, decrease the bending moment in z direction and shear in y direction so that the diagram is clearly visible to you all. So you can see the values are getting decreased. As you decrease it, the diagram will be larger to you. So decrease the values. Shear force is clearly visible to you all. Close the file. Then highlight MZ. Scale MZ. Again you have to decrease it from 45 to 10. So that it is clearly visible. Tell OK. Even displacement you can change now itself. Then later you can see the displacement of the beam, that is deflected shape of the beam. So we'll see one by one clearly now. Off, this is the deflected displacement, shear force diagram, then the bending moment diagram. Then you can go to the report page directly. You can report setup. So the report itself is ready for you all now. Go to the report page. So report, add all the details whichever you have filled now. So send it on your right hand side. So all the report cases, that is beam section, material, support, releases, combination, load generation, everything will be present in your report. Tell OK. So you can go for the printing option directly. This tag gives the print of the report whatever you have created. Even you can take take pictures of bending moment diagram, shear force diagram and displacement diagram. Thank you.